Hello, this is Alex, and in this video, we're going to make a Flappy Bird template using Koji. So we're going to do that by first pasting in an existing Flappy Bird code base, which is made, in this case, by the Coding Train, which is a very cool YouTube channel that teaches you how to write code in P5. So we're going to take these files and then put them into Koji, add a lot of customization options, and then put it on the template store. So let's get started. First, we're going to templates, and then we're going to start with a scaffold. So a scaffold is nice because it has everything that we would want to make a project in Koji already in it. You don't have to do any crazy configuration or anything. That's all been handled for you. So let's do a new template and create this project. So this project will spin up and get everything together and then drop us in our editor in about 30 seconds. Wonderful, there we go. All right, here is our Koji project. You can see that we have this sample output that is running P5, and we can see what that looks like by going to front end, pages, homepage, index.js has everything we could ever want in it. You can see it's running all of the code that's being rendered right here. So we don't want this code, we want Flappy Bird. So let's go back to this GitHub repository and paste in all of this code to get started. So we're just going to paste all three of these files just into that index.js in Koji, just because it's easier to do for right now. That is sketch, and then we need pipe. Put that right below. And then lastly, we need bird. And wonderful, looks like it's all there and ready to go. And I'm going to get rid of a console out in here, this one, because that was giving me trouble earlier. And there we go, the preview is already updated and everything is running. So it's looking a little bit weird in this window. So the first thing that I want to do before we get started on Koji customizations is change the canvas size from 64480 to just whatever the window size is. So we can do that with window inner width, yes, and then window inner height. Then we can see it in the Koji preview window. Awesome. And then here is our game. So this is technically a fully functioning app that already looks pretty cool, but now we're going to extend it and make it even better using Koji. So the first thing that we're going to do is put in, we have these nice customization options. We have the background color. There's not really a need for a text color, but let's try background color first. So we can go back to our index.js and let's put this into our project. So we can put koji.colors, which is the name of that file, .backgroundColor. Save that. And now the background of our app is the background color in customizations. So this can automatically update on the fly. Awesome. So let's keep going down that vein. And let's change the pipe color to be something that we can customize as well. So inside of this visual editor is really just a JSON file that gets sent to the application and then loaded into the application. So let's change around text color. We don't need a text color. Let's make a pipe color. Awesome. And then this is the data that gets sent, and then this is the nice display that you can see in this editor right here. So let's change text color to pipe color. And change it in both of these places as well. Whoops. Awesome. So now we have a visual for that. Let's make it green. That's good green. Yeah. But now it doesn't update in the pipes yet. We have to tell our software to do that. So if we go down to wherever we pasted pipe, which is right here, you can see the fill 255 means fill in with white, which is what's happening right now. Let's tell that to fill in with our new pipe color. Perfect. Then it will update automatically. So let's keep going with this customization. Right now, the bird is just this little ball, but I think it should be an image. So let's add that into images. Right now, we just have the P5 logo that was already in here. Let's change the name of that to bird. And not the best description ever, but I think they'll get the idea. Awesome. So now this is our bird image, and I'm going to keep it with the asterisk for now. But this could be any sort of image at all. Let's go back to our index, and then we need to use P5 to make a render an image. Let's do a bird image, declare that, and then we need to load it in setup, which I believe is a load image. Bird image is equal to load image, and then that is the image from our settings, so that would be an images.bird. All right, so now we loaded our bird image, so let's render it as the bird. So we can go down to the show function of our bird, and instead of an ellipse, let's comment that out for now. Let's instead put image, and that was called bird image. That would be at this.x and this.y, and we're going to keep it 32 by 32. And that'll update, and here is our image. Awesome, that was easy enough. So, looks like this game is fully customized. We can break it out into a new window as well to see that it will work on any sized screen. Awesome. So, if you wanted to go even further, you could add like game settings, like you can change the pipe speed, change the pipe size, other cool stuff like that. I'm gonna leave it like this for right now. So I think we are good to go with this template. Everything is set up and ready. So to submit this as a template, we need to start inside of here and open up our terminal. So we need to tell Koji that this is code that we wanna use for a template. So we need to use this cool tool called Git and register our code into Koji. That's nice and easy. Let's do a Git add all, then a git commit, and you can look up what these commands mean, but they pretty much just put things in a git repository. And let's say Flappy Bird. So the git repository tied to this project is origin master. Awesome. And that will have everything configured and ready to go for us. So we'll put it into projects. So let's copy this link. We're going to need it later. And it looks like we got everything we need from this editor. So let's turn this into a template now. We can do that by going back to projects, back to templates, open our developer portal, and then make a new template. And you might have to opt into template store, have some terms and conditions. That only takes a second. So our template is Flappy Bird. Get that started. and store listing, make a description, and our tags. This is a game, and then upload an image. I found this nice one. Make it look nice. And then our details, this is where we talk about what the template is and what it has in it. Cool. And that's in Markdown, so you can use all kinds of styling. And that looks great. Save and continue. And now we need to tell the template creation page what template we want to use, which is the link that we just copied. We can paste that right into here, and we don't need stubs because this is hosted on Koji. We can save and continue. It'll give us a nice looking window that basically just means that we need to build our project. So Koji is going to open up our project, get everything nice and ready to go for a template, and rebuild everything. And that's going to take about 2 minutes. All right, and now everything is put together. Now we just need to make sure that this is our app and everything is running as we want to, because this is exactly what people that copy our template will see. And everything looks wonderful. Cool, let's go back to our projects. Oh, that actually opens in a new tab. So let's go back to this tab. And yes, our project is great. And now you have a choice to put in a license. You can put in the MIT license, whatever thing you like. And you can also either allow or not allow for the template you created to be made into another template. So I'm gonna allow redistribution on this template, because what if someone adds some other cool configuration options or makes something else that extends Flappy Bird? I want them to make another cooler version. So we're going to save and continue. Then you agree to some terms and conditions and submit your project. And then you just need to wait to get a review from the Koji developers, and it will be in the template store. We successfully copied in Flappy Bird into Koji, added a bunch of cool customization settings, and then submitted our template to the template store. Thanks for watching. If you learned something new, learn from the video, don't forget to like. If you had trouble anywhere or need some help, you can leave a comment, and I'll be looking out for those. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.